Testing. There's no test here.
Live with Triton Football. It's Friday Night Live. Tonight we're at Laguna Hills High School. Your San Clemente Tritons against the El Toro Chargers. Welcome to Friday Night Live. Myself, Rich Corder, Ben Villa, and Chris Davies. And welcome to the show. And before we give the information on our sponsors, or we're going to give you the information on our sponsors first, then Ben Villa will be giving you the information on the players of tonight's game.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. We're coming into our second and final preseason game for San Clemente, and we are at Laguna Hills High School. El Toro High School does not have a lighted field, and they share a field with Tribeco Hills. Unfortunately, Tribeco Hills is building a parking structure, and there's very limited parking, so El Toro tonight will be playing at the campus of Laguna Hills High School. Tonight, El Toro High School Chargers, dressed in their blue and gold uniforms, come into this game with an 0-4 record. They've had some tough times their first four games. El Toro is in their CV League, and this will be their fifth preseason game. Their first game, they played Cajon and lost 26-13. They played Denny Hills by a score of 56-21, and for those San Clemente fans out there can make a score comparison tonight. Then they played Capitol Valley and lost to Capitol Valley 21-17. And then they played last week Laguna Hills, and Laguna Hills, who has an outstanding team, defeated El Toro 33-7. So they come into this game 0-4 and looking for their first win. El Toro is coached by Jake Hadley. And last week, well, actually for the season, El Toro comes in with an average of 14 points per game having scored, and they've allowed 34 points per game. El Toro is led by their running back Nathan Baca with 12 points and Jesse Buena with 12 points. And their kicker, Vince D'Amato, has 16 points on 7 extra points and 3 field goals. El Toro is led by their rushing leader, Andrew Wellman, who has 146 yards on 41 carries for 365 yards for an average of 3.6. On the receiving end, El Toro is led by Jesse Bueno, who's 233 yards on 17 receptions. He averages 13.7 yards per reception, and his longest reception is 25 yards. El Toro, which is kind of unique, uses a three-man rotation at the quarterback position, and that should be interesting to watch tonight. They're led by Sean Kelly, who is 17 for 37, having passed for 194 yards. Brayden Olson is 14 for 38 for 233 yards. And Cody Fields is 11 for 31 with 164 yards. And they have a combined 42 attempts for 106 yards. And their total is, for the three quarterbacks, is 591 yards for an average of 147.8 yards per game. Obviously, running the three quarterbacks, they're be running an offense that may be a little bit complicated because one of them is a passer, one's a runner, one's a combination of both, so they'll be running all three quarterbacks into the game. San Clemente comes into this game on a roll. They're 3-0, having defeated El Camino 17-13, Tribeco Hills 41-17, and Santa Fe by a score of 21-7. San Clemente is averaging 26.3 points per game, and the defense is really stingy this year. They've only allowed 9 points per game. The individual leaders for San Clemente leading in the scoring is David Espino, who has 42 points for a 14 point per game average. Aaron Jones, the place kicker, has 12 points on 9 extra points and 1 field goal. And rushing for the Tritons, they're led by DJ Gallegos, who's 168 yards on 19 carries for an 8.8 average. And he's followed by David Espino. You know, even though David has more carries and more yardage, his average is a little less than DJ, but David Espino is 177 yards on 41 carries for an average of 4.3 per game. On the receiving end, Duke DeLancelotti has finally come into his own. He's found Graham Tenning the last two games, and Graham leads the team with 11 receptions for 142 yards, his longest being 64 yards, and Graham has one TD. And he's followed by David Espino, who has 8 receptions for 75 yards, and David's longest is 23 yards. And the young man that's really stepped up the last two games and has moved into a starting position is Dominic Ela, who has got 7 receptions for 72 yards, and he's averaging 10.3 yards per carry, and his longest is 21 yards. So Duke DeLancelotti, whose passing game has picked up, is 37 completions on 57 attempts, and he's averaged 64.9% of his passing attempts. He's thrown for 414 yards, and his longest 64 yards. He's thrown one interception, two TDs. So the Sacramento's passing game has picked up the last two games, and Duke has found his receiver. We're going to pause for a minute while we hear the national anthem. And we're back for tonight's game between Sacramento and El Toro. And we're at Laguna Hills High School. For those of you who are interested in this week's county rankings, Mission Viejo has moved into the top position with a 4-0 record. And Servite is second, 3-1. Modern Day, 3-1. Los Alamitos, 3-0. Edison, 3-1. Orange Lutheran, 3-1. And seventh to be Tesoro with 4-0, and San Clemente comes in an eighth with a 3-0 record. They're followed by Esperanza at 2-1, and Newport brings in at the 10th position with a 2-1 record. And next week, San Clemente plays La Habra High School, and they're ranked 11th. And Dana Hills, who will be in our schedule, is ranked number 13. So the rankings, which is kind of unique in that there are four Sunset teams and in the top 10, three Trinity League teams and three South Coast teams. So the top 10 is monopolized by three leagues in Orange County, the Sunset, Trinity, and South Coast. So I guess that's indicative of where all the strength in the football programs are. Tonight, being in Laguna Hills High School, we're This week we're at, on top of the broadcast booth, and our view is of rolling hills. We can see the sunset coming down.
And we're freezing.
It's not freezing. Rich and I have had some experiences as far as broadcasting locations. One time we were broadcasting in Huntington Beach, and there was no booth. We actually had to sit. We're sitting in the stands with most of the people broadcasting.
Yeah, first game. That was the first one.
And then we had another great experience. We had went down to San Diego Marion High School. We were actually on a makeshift wooden
supposed to be a bleacher,
it was. We're in the middle of the trees. Let me put it that way. It looked like a tree house, and that was kind of scary.
And with the possums.
Yeah. And we've been up to Valencia, up in by Santa Clarita, where it was really, really cold. We couldn't dress warm enough. That was for a playoff game. So we've been in a lot tougher, stranger, more inconvenient areas to broadcast. So this is kind of nice, but it's getting football weather. It's kind of cool. Everybody's got their jackets on. So we're starting to feel the weather for football. Tonight's San Clemente comes in, and they're going to have three starters not playing tonight. Ryan DeLeon has a separated shoulder, so he won't play tonight. They're going to keep him out for this week's game. And Aaron Jones, the place kicker, defensive back, he's got a pulled quad, and so they're going to keep him out. And Jack Anderson, who's had an outstanding three games defensively, who's probably the stalwart of our defensive team, he's out for tonight's game. He injured his shoulder, and they're just taking precautionary measures to not lose him for the season. So he's going to sit out this game. So we're going to have some new faces out there on defense and on the offense. But tonight, San Clemente will start Evan Jacobson at center, and the down linemen will be Steven Watts, A.J. Marino, Austin Klinkenbeer, and Scott Gruber. At the receivers will be Ben Gomez and Graham Tenney, and Steve Brandenburg now steps up into a starting position. At the running backs will be David Espino and DJ Gallegos, and the quarterback for San Clemente will be number 8, Duke DeLancelotti. On the defensive end, the down linemen will be Austin Klinkenbeard, Ricky Carter, and Alex Kahn. At the linebackers be Dylan Reba, Joey Waters, and Joe Wilson. There was no indication yet as to who the other linebacker was going to be in place of Jack Anderson. They hadn't decided yet. At the corners will be Josh Left and William Tober. And at the safeties will be Ben Gomez and Jordan Gerardo. And he will be replacing Aaron Jones for tonight. So they'll have three new players in there. I'm sure El Toro will notice that they've got replacements in there, and they'll probably go right after them early in the game to see if they can make some plays and get into the game. So tonight should be interesting. We have a team that's on a roll. Hopefully San Clemente does not get complacent, plays their regular game, and it should be a relative not easy game, but San Clemente should be able to win this game. El Toro comes here a little bit on the desperate side. They're 0-4, and they need a win before league. They've got a bye next week, so they'll have 2 weeks to recoup from any injuries. But El Toro needs a win desperately, so they're going to do whatever they can to pull out a win. San Clemente, all they got to do is maintain their poise, play their game like they know they can, and it should be, I hate to jinx them, but it should be a fairly easy game for San Clemente.
Hey, we should give out a shout to the lower levels. The JV won yesterday. They won 27-19. Freshman team that Ben and I coach, we won 42-12. And today, the B team, our Killer Bees, won 38-0. So we're looking for a clean sweep on all levels with tonight. Our freshman football team is now 4-0 heading into La Habra next week, and we'll be playing at home at San Clemente against La Habra, and that's going to be a tough, tough team. But, hey, we're looking forward to it, right, Ben?
That's right. It's football season. It's the weather is football season, and we're on a winning streak right now. Everybody's playing well, so everybody is on a high note right now.
How about the play of David Espino? Has just been outstanding the last few weeks. Like we were saying last week, is he was injured in his freshman year, he was injured in his sophomore year, and this year he's healthy and he's out there and he is just running the ball. He is doing such a great job. Like 7 touchdowns in the last two games, coach, something like that.
Yeah.
He's just unbelievable. Yeah. He's just what a great running back. He's been doing a great job.
Yeah, when we thought we would be lacking in the running game because the kids were so inexperienced, David has just stepped up and done an excellent job. And right behind him is DJ Gallegos, who some of the coaches are even thinking of putting him at the defensive side of the ball, but he stepped up his running and will probably make his career back there on the offensive side. Also, what Duke has stepped up his passing. He was struggling his first two games and kind of stepped it up the last two games, and he's found his favorite receiver, Graham Tenney, who's had some outstanding games the last two. And then Dominic Ela has also stepped up, coming in from a reserve position to make some outstanding catches and helping out with the passing offense, and he's earned the right to start tonight. So he'll be
there. We go.
So San Clemente will be receiving the ball tonight. And we'll start San Clemente's fourth game.
Ben Gomez and David Espino are going to be standing back on the 3-yard line. The kick is up. Looks like it's going to be into the end zone, and it will be. And so San Clemente is going to come out. It'll be first and 10 starting on the 20-yard line, moving left to right. Big game for San Clemente, hopefully to go 4-0 tonight.
We're at a disadvantage here, ladies and gentlemen. Not a disadvantage, but it's going to be kind of loud. We're going to have to yell. Unfortunately, we're high atop the broadcast booth, but right next to in our right ear is the speaker from the announcer. Hopefully, he doesn't do a play-by-play description of the game.
Yeah.
Because this is screaming loud up here.
So Espino's going to be the lone setback to the left. DeLancelotti is going to be the quarterback and gun. Dubs formation. Opening play of the first quarter, three-step drop, quick pass on the right side to Ben Gomez, gets out to the 27-yard line, where it's going to be second down and about 3.
That was a pass to Gomez. Ben came back from the line of scrimmage. He came back to receive the ball. He actually got it back at the line of scrimmage, and the down linemen were able to go forward and weren't out in the pass routes, but that was a nice game.
Second down, DeLancelotti and gun. The giver on the left side to DJ Gallegos. He gets out to about the 29-yard line, where he's going to be about 1 yard short, where it'll be third down and a long one. Just the opening minute of the first quarter here. We're at Laguna Hills High School. El Toro doesn't have a home field. Normally they play at Tribuco, but Tribuco's under major construction right now. So they've been playing their home games here at Laguna Hills. Ben Gomez is going to be split out to the right. DeLancelotti is going to be a gun. Motion. The give to Espino, and he's going to be stopped short. He's going to be no gain. San Clemente is going to have to punt the ball here. He was stopped. He ran up the left side of the formation, and he was stopped for no gain. So El Toro does the job right away and stops San Clemente in 3 plays. Now pending the punt.
Well, that's the first play that David Espino has been stopped. I can't ever recall him being stopped at the line of scrimmage.
Brandenburg is going to be standing back at the 12-yard line to snap. The punt's up. It's going to be field and fair catch right at the 35-yard line, where El Toro is going to take over first and 10, moving right to left. No score here to go in the first quarter, 10-15 to go.
Steve Brandenburg will be doing the punting in place of Aaron Jones, who's injured tonight and won't see any action. He's not even dressed tonight. But Steve Brandenburg's outstanding player who'll do a fine job. in the punting area.
Okay, the quarterback, El Toro, has three receivers spread formation to the right. The quarterback, number 12, Cody Fields, will be up under center. He takes a five-step drop, steps up into the pocket. He's got pressure, and he's brought down at the 30-yard line.
Wow, that was a great job by the defensive backs. Fields was back there for a very long time trying to find the receivers. His receivers were almost 20 yards down, and they were well covered by San Clemente. He had no one to throw to, and finally the defensive line was able to get to him for a loss.
Alex Kahn on the tackle. Two receivers split to the right, single receiver split to the left. I formation, the quarterback Fields up under center. San Clemente almost jumped right there. Motion, the run around the left side of the formation, and he gets knocked out of bounds at the 31-yard line. The running back, Mark Fisher.
That was a nice pursuit. Joey Waters may have knocked him out, but Josh Leff did an outstanding job of staying to the outside and stringing that run and not allowing the ball carrier to get to the outside. Forced the runner to come inside, and then Joey Waters was there to make the tackle.
So third down and 13, 9:29 to go in the first quarter, no score. Bunch formation, three receivers to the right. Quarterback Fields up under center. Take the five-step drop under pressure. Oh, almost picked off by San Clemente. Nice job.
Yeah, they're... That was a nice cover job by San Clemente. They put a lot of pressure on him, and Jordan Girard was there to almost make the interception.
Girardo played for us here a couple years ago as a freshman. He was only, that's the year we lost 10 starters, and him and Johnny Martinez were the only two guys that remained healthy through the whole season. So Tenney's going to be standing back on the 30-yard line waiting for the El Toro punt here. Running into the kicker. Oh, man, running into the kicker. That's going to come back.
Yeah, and it'll be first down.
Yeah, it was. Yeah, the San Clemente defensive player is trying to say that he tipped the ball, but...
No, it was Josh Leff. He was there to block the ball, but then he changed his mind on blocking, and it was going to allow the punter to punt it, but then his momentum carried him into the punter, and that was called for roughing.
That's going to be a 15-yarder, too, so... Ball's going to come out to the 35-yard line. Oh, wait a minute. They have to still mark it out. It's going to be up around the 45-yard line. Right at the 47. So El Toro's going to take over first down. Ball's going to be on the 47-yard line. No score here to go in the first quarter. They'll be moving right to left. First down on the running into the kicker. Two receivers split to either side of the formation, Dubs formation. Fields, the quarterback, up under center. Lone setback. He's going to roll out to the right side. He's got under pressure, and he throws that away.
Boy, Ricky Carter put some pressure on him and made Fields run, and he was never set well enough to make a good throw. It almost looked like he was just trying to get rid of the ball because Ricky Carter was right on his heels to make the play. So Fields made a nice job just getting rid of the ball.
Yeah, he did. He threw it. And besides the fact that there were three Triton defenders right around the receiver. So spread formation, spread right, three receivers. Fields up under center. The running back is Smith. Three-step drop. Oh, had an open receiver going down the right side, but he overthrew him. It was Jennings. So it's going to bring up third down and 10.
Oh, yeah, the receiver was wide open.
Yeah, he was.
Threw it behind him. The receiver couldn't come back for the ball. I don't know. I mean, the DB, Ben Gomez, just gave too much room. Gomez was ahead of him, but he was like 5 yards away from the receiver. Fortunately, it was a bad pass.
So tonight is Cox game of the week again. We've been getting a few of those this year.
Yeah.
We keep getting booted. We're the rookies, Coach. Three receivers spread to the right.
What do you mean we?
Thank you. Fields up under center. Lone setback. Three-step drop. Up. Oh. Nice job by Sacramento. Almost picked off. So it's going to bring a fourth down and a punting situation for El Toro.
Again, Fields can't find his, well, he can find his receivers. He just can't get set to make a good pass. He's all his passes have been off balance. And San Clemente just putting the pressure on him. But El Toro does not have a very strong running game, so they're going to depend on their three quarterbacks. And right now, Fields can do a better job.
Look at this formation, Coach. They got spread, and they're going to punt out of it. Boy, you got to watch that because they could run or they could pass out of that formation. Coach Jaime Ortiz, defensive coordinator, doing a good job putting pressure, having the defense put pressure. Kenny's going to make a fair catch down at the 18-yard line where Sacramento is going to take over first and 10, moving left to right. It's 8:40 to go in the first quarter. No score, and Sacramento is going to get the ball for the second time.
Well, San Clemente is going to have to establish their running game. They tried to do it the first their first series, but David Espino got stopped for no game on the third and down. But, well, it looks like San Clemente is coming out in a spread formation, and it looks like they're going to throw the ball.
San Clemente has three receivers spread to the right. Delancelot is going to be in gun. Espino's going to be lone set back to the left or to his right. He's going to roll out to the left side. He's got Ben Gomez. Oh, man, almost dropped that ball. Nice job by Gomez to hang on. That's going to be a first down. He's going to get out to the 31-yard line.
Yeah,
so it's going to be first down.
That was a nice effort by Ben. Second effort got him the first down. He got another 3 or 4 yards.
Yeah, what a, you know, Ben Gomez, what a great, he's a great running back. And what a nice kid, too. He's a super athlete. Yeah, he's just a great athlete. He does a great job out there. Never give up for that kid. You got a single receiver split out to the left. Motion. You give her on the left side to Gallegos. Got a little bit of running room, 35. It's going to be out to the 40. And it's going to be just short by about a yard. So it's going to be a second down and one. Ben was just saying, time to establish the running game. And that's exactly what Sacramento is doing now. And you have to forgive us, Triton fans. We've got, like Ben says, we got the right above us to the right is the loudspeaker, and then right below us directly is the band. So we've got a little competition with noise tonight. Dub formation, two receivers to either side. The give to Espino, he's got running room. He's going to get out to the 48-yard line, where it'll be first down San Clemente. 7:37 to go in the first quarter. No score here from Laguna Hills High School, where El Toro's playing your San Clemente Tritons.
Yeah, San Clemente, I don't think El Toro can stop San Clemente's running game. So they're going to use the passing game to set up their running game.
Dubs formation. Delancelotti in gun. He's going to throw a quick pass out to the left side to Tenney. He's got some running room. He catches it. And he gets out right at the maybe 39-yard line, where it's going to be first down again.
Yeah, so
great job by Delancelotti throwing the pass to Tenney.
So now San Clemente gets three consecutive first downs. They're on a roll. Now they're inside the El Toro's 40-yard line.
So first down, 7:33 here to go. No score. Single receiver Gomez split to the right. Delancelotti is going to be up under center. Motion to give to Espino. He's going to get down to about the 37-yard line for just about a 3-yard gain, where it'll be second down and 7.
That was a nice play by San Clemente. Gallegos going to the right, and they fake the handoff to him and gave the handoff to Espino going left, and picks up 3 yards.
This time, DeLancelotti is going to be in gun formation. Two receivers split to the left. Espino, the lone step back to the right. It's going to take a three-step drop. Oh, and it's off the receiver, intercepted by El Toro. And he brings it out to the 31-yard line. Was that off of Tenney? Was that Tenney?
That was intended for Tenney and hit him off the shoulder, bounced off his shoulder. It was intercepted by El Toro.
That's a rare drop there by Tenney. Tenney's got soft hands. He's a great receiver. Just happened to pop off, and it looked like it hit his pads or something. So now El Toro's moving. They're moving right to left. We got two receivers split to the right. Single receiver split to the left. It's going to give up the middle for about a two-yard gain, where it's going to be second down and about eight.
Well, San Clemente right now's offense is allowing El Toro to stay in this game. Their inability to get a first down on a third and one, they lost that drive, and then on this drive they have an interception. El Toro gets the ball back. So to this point, San Clemente is allowing El Toro to stay in the game.
So second down and seven. The toss to the right side of the formation. It's got a couple of yards. The running back, Wellman.
Well, here's another third down situation where San Clemente's got to step up and stop El Toro. They've already forced him to punt twice. So now they've got to stop him here and make him punt again so they get the offense back out here and let the offense do what they do well, and that's move the ball. They just can't be causing all these turnovers.
So the quarterback Fields is over talking to El Toro. Now they just called a timeout. So the head coach is running out on the field. San Clemente goes over the sidelines to talk to Coach Jaime Ortiz. Does a great job with the defense. The head coach, Eric Patton, offensive coordinator slash head coach, assistant head coach, is Coach Dave Brown. Does a great job running the fly offense, which is a misdirection offense. 5:20 here to go in the first quarter, no score.
San Clemente, again, has caused a turnover that's given the ball back to the opponents, and it seems like this has to happen at least one time in every game. San Clemente can make their lives a lot better if they would not cause turnovers that keeps the offense off the football field. The defense right now has spent a lot of time on the field.
So the quarterback Fields up under center, third down and three, split backs. Three-step drop, does a quick hitch over the left side where it's completed to Morgan. Out to the 44-yard line will be first down El Toro. The left receiver just ran a five-yard hitch. Just got the first down.
Well, it looks like the coach has settled down with Cody Fields as his lone quarterback. In previous games, he's been alternating three quarterbacks.
Two receivers split to the right. They give on the right side of the formation to the running back, Wellman.
And Wellman the ball carrier.
And he gets about 2 yards. It's going to be second down and eight. Want to thank our Friday Night Live sponsors, OC Tavern, Little Page Landscaping, Little Page Automotive, South Coast Distributing, Shirt Graphics, and our newest sponsor, R&R Custom Cabinets with Reno Roberti. We appreciate our support Friday Night Live for our sponsors. Wouldn't be here if it wasn't for them. Three receivers spread to the right, a toss to the right side for about a 1 yard gain.
There's a
flag. Smith is the ball carrier.
There's a flag on the
holding El Toro.
Yeah, Ben Gomez came up to make an outstanding play.
Oh, 4:21 to go in the first quarter. Still no score. And it's being marched off against El Toro. Ball's going to go back to about the 36-yard line. Where it's going to be second down and about maybe 18. Boy, I tell you, we got the band below us, the speaker beside us. This is like a Tribuco, remember that?
I got you beside me.
Oh, thank you. I got you, babe.
No.
Wasn't there a song like that? Ben, don't try to kiss me. Get away from me.
Noise. That's all I get is noise. Got it all around me.
Two receivers split to either side. We didn't even make it through the first quarter. You're already ragging on me, Ben. Ben and I go way back here. We have a good time doing this. So two receivers split to either side.
We do?
I think so. The quarterback fields up under center. It's a three-step drop. Off his hands over on the foot. Would have been caught on the 40-yard line.
Wow.
So it's going to be third down and 18. 4:06 to go here in the first quarter. No score.
San Clemente always seems to have problems with third and long. Third and longs have always stayed in my mind as San Clemente in pivotal games.
Dr. Doom, now stop that.
Remember that third and long against Servite game we should have won?
Oh, my God, Ben. You're already back last year.
Yeah, I know. I can't help it.
This is game four this year, Coach.
I know. Those things bother me.
It sounds like it. Three receivers split to the right. Spread formation. Five-step drop. He's got time. Overthrew his receiver by about 10 yards. So it's going to bring up fourth down and 18. So a punting situation. And it looks like San Clemente be getting the ball back, as long as they don't run into the kicker this time.
Yeah, well, at that time, Fields had plenty of time to make that long throw. That was about a 30-yard throw. Unfortunately, his receiver was only 25 yards out.
So four minutes to go exactly here in the first quarter. No score. Tenney's going to be standing back about the 28-yard line. Again, that last pass that Tenney dropped, boy, he's got soft hands. He's got great hands. You know, it's rare to see that. I can't remember the last time I saw him drop a pass. So the kick is up. Tenney's going to come up, field it, and he's going to breaks a tackle. Nice job. He's still on his feet. Gets out to the 39-yard line where it's going to be first down. San Clemente maybe looks like he'll be spotted right at the 40. San Clemente's going to take over, moving left to right. No score here to go in the first quarter, 3:49 to go.
Well, let's see now if San Clemente can get a consistent drive here and get in the end zone. They'll come out with a no huddle.
This is the first game we've done for this school, Coach. First time we've been here in the 5 years of Friday Night Live.
Yeah.
Three receivers spread to the left. Chris Davies, our technical engineer, that's bringing you this over the live video. Quarterback keeper by DeLancelotti. He's got some running room to the 50, 45. Gets stopped at about the 44-yard line. Nice job on the quarterback keeper. So it's going to be first down on the 44-yard line. Nice job by DeLancelotti.
Yeah, Duke's got to do that. Not that he should do it a whole lot, but he's got to run with the ball every once in a while to keep the DBs from going deep with his receivers and not allowing the linebackers to drop deep into the passing zones. If he runs a couple of times like that, those linebackers got to stay up and honor his running ability.
Spread formation, three receivers to the left. He's running an option to the right side, and he keeps it himself. Gets ahead for maybe a yard gain. Remember, Triton fans, if you're out there, give us a shout, say hello, let us know where you are. Right now we've got some long distance. We got Norwalk, we have Calabasas, Oregon, Pennsylvania.
Oregon.
Does that say Frackville, Pennsylvania? Boston, Massachusetts, Boise, Idaho.
Hey, Greg Domichini, are you in Oregon?
Two receivers put to either side. The giver on the left side to Gallegos. He's got some running room. He's going to be down close to a first down.
No, they should continue to run the ball. El Toro has not been able to stop the run other than the run by Espino, but they have not been able to stop that run. They should just continue to do it.
First down, Coach.
On that, hey, Greg, up there in Oregon, if that's you, give us a call.
Send us an email. Let us know where you are. You got family here playing, or if your family out of town, let us know. Friends, ex-Tritons, alumni.
I need to know if Kathy's still in the area.
Three receivers. Ben, don't be. No, never mind. Three receivers split to the right.
Oh, the get pass. On the ball. Get on the ball. Oh, that, to me, could that looked
been.
Like a.
Almost. Almost. He was just trying to turn that field, but that could have been
backward
behind
pass.
The lateral. Yeah, exactly. So that was lucky. So first down and 10. I'm agreeing with you right now. I think we ought to just run that football right now. El Toro's having a tough time of stopping the fly, which is misdirection. And the way that Espino and DJ are running the ball, three receivers split to the right, single receiver split to the left. Lancelotti in gun. He's going to roll to the right side. He steps up. Almost right through the hands of Ben Gomez, and who was behind him? Was that DJ? Can't see who the other running back or the other receiver was.
No, it looks 33 like DJ
Gallegos.
I don't know, but both DJ and Ben Gomez were within 2 yards
two
of each
inches.
Other.
Yeah, exactly.
One of them ran the wrong route because they were together and they had one defender covering them both, but they went to a pass. Now we got a third and 10. Which is a passing situation, which is...
Spread formation, three receivers to the right. It's Lancelotti and gun. He's going to take a three-step drop. He's got a receiver open. Nice job, Ela, down to the 20-yard line, where it's going to be first down, San Clemente. Great job by Ela.
Flag.
Uh-oh.
It's got to be unsportsmanlike.
Let's see what this is.
It was a little late for face mask, though.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking at first. I almost wondered... Maybe something.
Oh, personal foul.
There you go.
Dead ball foul.
So it's going to be first down, San Clemente. And then get back to Ela. What a great kid he is. Good receiver. Really came on. He came on and started coming on last year. Now this year he's one of their top receivers, him and Tenney. And he does a great job of catching the ball, too. You don't see him drop many passes. What a nice kid, too. I can't remember. I think we may have talked to him tonight. Ela, yeah, we have to check the halftime. Can't remember, but I think I talked to him.
You have a short memory last, Coach?
I do, Coach. Thank you for asking, though. Mm-hmm. They give around the right side. The Gallegos, he's dropped at about the 10-yard line for no gain, maybe the half a yard. So second down. Now, where's that ball spotted? Is that going to be, is it second and goal right there? Looks like it's right just inside the 10, so it must be second and goal, just barely inside the 10.
I got a feeling San Clemente is going to be passing the ball here.
I think they ought to run it. Two split backs. Motion. They give up to Spino on the right side. Nice job. Gets down to the 5-yard line where it's going to be third down and 5. 1:09 to go here in the first quarter. No score. Here's San Clemente Titans against the El Toro Chargers.
Well, San Clemente's third down and goal. They're just inches inside the 5-yard line. So San Clemente's got to get in here. I doubt if they don't make it that they'll try on the fourth down. They'll probably go for the field goal. But
remember, they got a new field goal kicker, Coach. Two receivers put to either side. The Lancelotti and gun. I wouldn't be surprised to see him take off running. Espino, long setback to the right. Three-step drop.
Nice.
Touchdown, San Clemente. Nice
Tenney.
Pass.
Nice kick by Graham
Tenney. Nice job by Lancelotti.
That was a nice pattern by Graham. He's playing on the outside. Did a slant to the outside, turned and came back across the middle, and he was wide open.
There's Mr. He had that one that he dropped, and he caught this one. It's perfect. Just good concentration. Nice pass by DeLancelotti. So San Clemente draws first blood, 6-0. 29 seconds to go in the first quarter. Pending the kick by Brandenburg. And it's up. And it is good. And during the week, I remember at practice, we saw Steve out there practicing Brandenburg kicking. And Steve's a good kid, too. He's got a good leg. So with that, now it's 7-0. 29 seconds here to go in the first quarter. San Clemente has drawn first blood. So they passed a little bit more on that last drive, Coach.
Yeah. They should, obviously they'll use their passing to throw a little bit just to keep El Toro off balance. But tonight they should be relying on their running game to carry them through because El Toro can't stop their running game.
Okay, so Brandenburg is going to be dropping back to kick the ball here. El Toro has six receivers. They have them spread out every 10 yards.
Number 21, John Priester back for El
in the end zone. That's going to come out to the 20-yard line. Now Toro's going to be moving right to left. Across your computer screen here, and it is 29 seconds to go here in the first quarter. San Clemente leading 7-0. Anybody emailing in, Chris? Nobody yet? Chris says he's cold and loud out here, and that speaker is really loud up above us. And the band's quiet right now. Yeah. Chris has earplugs in, it's still loud. So, bunch formation, San Clemente just jumped off sides.
That was Ricky Carter, the nose.
Watch the ball, goes, Ricky.
And he's the ball's right over his nose and he jumps off sides. There's a Ricky's a young man who started out as a freshman year, never having played football, and we made turn him into a linebacker. They went to running back, and they needed a lineman. They put him down defensive line.
So two split backs, motion. Fields up under center. It's going to be the give all the way out to about the 31-yard line. Wellman is going to be a first down.
Another note on Ricky. Ricky plays a nose guard, and he will be outweighed most of the year by at least 50 to 100 pounds per man. Ricky's not your big 300-pounder. Ricky probably goes like around 220, and he'll be going against guys 300 pounds.
Bunch formation, three receivers to the left, Fields up under center. Should be the last play of the first quarter. The draw, and he gets out to the 36-yard line, where it's going to be second down and about four. And that's going to do it for the first quarter. So at the end of the first quarter, San Clemente ahead 7-0.
Well, San Clemente in this quarter established their running game. If it hadn't been for the turnover, they might have had another score. But San Clemente's defense ought to step up. And the offense has got to do what they do best, and that's run the ball. And they've got to just keep a consistent game and not cause turnovers or have penalties at critical times of the game. So I'm sure the coaches out there are telling what they have to do. The defense is going to be coming back, and El Toro will be second and about 4 yards for the first down. So, a quick note on Ricky Carter. You'll notice he's got the number 23, which is unique. There aren't very many down linemen who have the number 23, and that's because of his making his contribution of getting on the defensive line, going from a linebacker to defensive lineman.
So two receivers put to the right, I formation, Fields up under center. Three-step drive. He's got an open receiver, and he catches the ball out at the right about the 33-yard line. Right. That's a nice catch by number 18, Bueno.
Yeah,
so first down.
He got behind William Tober, and Gomez couldn't react quick enough to get over. So William Tober's got to do a little bit better job protecting that deep pattern.
The run up the middle, he's got some running room, almost broke a tackle. That was Andrew Wellman. It's going to be down around that 23-yard line, and San Clemente now is bending a little bit on this drive by El Toro.
Right, El Toro's driving on him and on the run, so I think El Toro's going to bend in their passing game right now and just stay with the run. It's working for him against San Clemente's defense.
Two receivers split to the right, I formation. Fields up under center. A fumble. San Clemente may have this ball. No. They got the running back. Smith, he got it back. I just had to pick up the binos on that play, and I had to be looking at the exchange. And it hit the slide pad or something of the running back, and the ball popped up. And everybody was grabbing for it. El Toro was real lucky to get that ball back.
Well, San Clemente's got to do a better job of on the defensive line. Right now, they're running on them.
Three receivers, bunch formation to the left. Quarterback up under center. Five-step drop. Oh. That was deflected at the line of scrimmage. Nice job by the San Clemente defense. Bring up fourth down.
Alex Kahn stuck his big mitt up there and deflected the ball. So now it's fourth. Now it's fourth down, and we'll see if El Toro's going to try and kick the ball or go for a fourth. They're going to try and kick the field goal.
Field goal attempt. The tension is mounting, Coach. Pending the field goal here. San Clemente showing. Kick is up. That looks good.
Got good distance.
That was a good kick, and it's good.
That kick is good.
And with that, the score is now 7-3. So San Clemente now, they're going to get a chance to get the ball back. I think they ought to get back to the running game and start driving the ball down the field, eat up some of this clock. Let's put some more points on the scoreboard. Starting to get a lot of listeners coming in here now. 10:23 to go in the second quarter. San Clemente ahead, 7-3.
On the player's jersey or pants, take that over to the pet products table. You're a winner. $50 gift certificate.
San Clemente not got in the field for the kickoff return, and they've got Ben Gomez back there with David Espino.
Just had the Russinkovich family just sent us an instant message saying thank you to Friday Night Live, and talk about a great Triton football family. The three Russinkovich brothers all played for us, and the mom and dad, what a great family, a Triton, you know, strong tradition, Triton football family. Hey, we love you guys out there. Thanks for chiming in to Friday Night Live. Espino and Gomez. Looks like it's going to be into the end zone again. Yes, it is, and it's going to be brought out to the 20-yard line, where it'll be first down, moving right to left. 10:23 here to go in the second quarter. San Clemente ahead, 7-3.
Well, I think I would have thought that San Clemente would have had at least 14 points by this time. They've been struggling. They haven't had one good offensive drive, so let's see if they can put one together in this quarter and get those 14 points up, make it a little bit easier game.
DeLancelotti comes in. Espino set to his right. Two receivers set to either side of the formation. Motion. The give on the left side. That was number 85, Jordan Mickleff. It's just going to be second down and 5. Nice run by Mickleff. Came in motion from left, ran around the right side of the formation. So second down and 5. DeLancelotti gets the call from the sideline. San Clemente breaks the huddle. They're going to come out in a spread formation. Three receivers spread to the left side. Single receivers split to the right. DeLancelotti in gun. He's going to run. He's got heavy pressure. Get rid of it. Finds an open receiver. Oh, and dropped. Oh, that was a nice try by Ela. Just went off his hands. That was actually Gomez that threw the ball.
That was a nice job by the El Toro defensive man who came up, was able to knock that ball away. But that was a great move to evade the tackler.
Coach, we got to look here on the sideline. You know, Gomez is the quarterback now. I wonder if something happened to Lancelotti. I can't see DeLancelotti on the sideline, but Gomez is now the quarterback. We have three receivers spread to the left. Gomez, quarterback keeper up the middle. He's got a few, he's going to be about a yard short. He's going to come out to the 29-yard line, so San Clemente is going to have to punt again. I'm trying to see if I can't see Duke on the sideline.
Is he down on the bench somewhere?
I don't see him anywhere. Somebody stole Duke.
Well, he didn't walk off the field. I know that.
Six.
That was Brandenburg's punt. And it'll be short. And it'll take a couple
of passes. It takes a great roll for San Clemente. All the way down to about the
16
yard line. That rolled for about 12, 15 yards. That was a nice job. Yeah, I don't know, Titan fans. I don't know what happened to DeLancelotti. I don't see him. He's got to be over there somewhere. We just can't see him.
That looked like a 56-yard punt.
That was a nice punt. Now we'll have to see what happens when they come back. I don't see him sitting on the sideline, or standing on the sideline. There he is. He's right at the 35-yard line. Looks okay. Maybe just trying to mix it up a little bit with Ben Gomez. Talk about a great athlete. Two receivers put to either side to give up the right side. Boy, nice job of running the ball. The running back,
Kyle Smith,
gets out to the 24-yard line where it's going to be second down and about two.
That was a nice tackle by Joey Waters, the middle linebacker.
8:26 here to go in the second quarter. San Quentin ahead, 7-3. One receiver split to the right. That's movement by the right linemen on the offense for Toro. So that's going to come back 5 yards. There it goes. They'll march it back 5 yards. Second down at about seven. San Clemente leading 7-3 here in the second quarter. 8:17 to go. Kind of a sluggish game. You know, sometimes when you're going strong and then you end up playing a team that's not doing real well, you tend to play down a little bit. So, you know, San Clemente's got great coaches and they'll get these guys fired up. So it's just seems a little sluggish right now. Got to run to the left side for about a yard. Got somebody, who's this from, Chris? Oh, from Ray Villanueva. He's the head coach from the JV. He said congratulations on our win yesterday, the freshman. And also Ray, who's the head coach from the JV. They're doing a great job. They had a big win yesterday, won 27-19. I know you're at home, Ray, listening. Thank you for shouting in to us. Congratulations to you and you also. You and I go back a long time, Coach in San Clemente. You're a great guy. I'm proud to be a friend of you and to coach with you. Two receivers spread to the right. Now the both receivers moved. That's there kind of motion again.
Well, the center didn't snap the ball.
Yeah.
the receivers are down the field. The quarterback was stepping back in the passing, but he didn't have the ball. Center, I think, had a memory lapse and didn't snap the ball. But all the down linemen were down.
Somebody just sent in and said that San Clemente's playing like they're taking the night off because they're thinking about La Habra next week.
They probably are.
Yeah,
I kind of made that same statement
you
before
did.
The game. But
thank you, Dr. Doom.
You're welcome.
You jinxed us again, Ben.
No. I'm telling
right
you.
At the beginning of the game.
I'm telling you the truth.
Two receivers split to the right. Single receiver split to the left. Two split backs. Quarterback's going to be dropped. Back at the 10-yard line.
That's a nice job by Jack Straw, who came in from the right side linebacker position to make that tackle. Well, Toro will be punting right now, and they should be in pretty good field position. You got Tenney standing at the 48-yard line. So if he gets a good punt and gets a good run back, San Clemente should be have pretty good field position when they come out on the offense.
Ben, who's Peggy Peterson from Huntington Beach?
Ah, Peggy?
Ben, just said hello to Ben, Coach.
Yeah,
not
hi,
live.
Peggy.
Don't be using our broadcast for your personal life here, Coach. Come on now. Okay, the punt. Tenney's standing right on the 45-yard line. He's going to have plenty of room to run. Gets out to the 40, 35, 30. It's down to about, there's a flag on the play, so it's
looks,
inside the 25.
It might be a clip on
could
this
be.
Side.
So it's at the 23-yard line. Let's
the
see
flag's
what the
at the 34.
Holding San Clemente, so it's going to come back.
See, another.
Coach, don't start, Coach. Don't start. It's just a penalty. Just a penalty.
Yeah, just a penalty. Just an interception.
Coach, the game's not that boring yet. Let's not start singing. We're going to have
Kelly. Right. It's not boring. It's a 7-3 game against a team we should be beat by 21 points. It isn't boring.
Kelly Pollard's going to be sitting on his couch, falling off his couch, laughing at us again. Hey, speaking of Kelly, we haven't heard from Kelly yet tonight. Kelly, what are you doing out there? So, San Clemente's going to take over, first and 10, 7-3, 5:46 here to go in the second quarter.
Kelly, tell them, Rich, that you're laughing at him.
Two receivers split to the right. Two receivers split to the left. Motion. The give out the left side to Spino, and he gets nowhere. May have lost 1 yard. That time El Toro defense was waiting for him.
El Toro's doing a nice job in the pressure. They're not, their down linemen are coming across the line and maintaining their gaps and not over pursuing. They're allowing the ball carriers to come at them rather than them pursuing them, trying to throw them for a loss. They come straight across and then they just hold their position and the ball carriers are coming right at them.
So, DeLancelotti and gun. Espino set off to his left. Motion to give to Gallegos, who's got running room. Nice job. Breaks a tackle. Going to be across. Looks like enough for a first down. It's going to be really close. Down about the 27-yard line. Boy, that's good. First down, San Clemente. Nice job by Gallegos. You know, I really like the way he's running the ball this year. He is. He did a good job for us, but he's really running good. Him and Esposito. We don't have Ryan DeLeon, who's out this week with a shoulder separation. Hopefully, we talked to Patton earlier and said they're hoping he'll be back next week. But Gallegos and...
Do we have an Esposito on our team?
David Esposito. Espino. Thank you. Coach, always a wise guy. The keeper by DeLancelotti. He gets down right around the 15-yard line. This will be another first down. Nice run by DeLancelotti.
He's showing off his running ability right there.
David Espino.
But that Espino is pretty good, too.
God, Coach, I tell you, don't let anything go up here. I'm going to be waiting for you now.
Hey,
you better not call in wrong.
Kelly, would you call and give Rich some advice?
Hey, at least I'm not calling him Oceanside instead of El Camino this time.
Yeah.
Or say he ran it back to the 52-yard line.
52.
Two split backs. DeLancelotti up under center. One receiver split to the left. The give on the right side to Laba. Nice job all the way down to about the 2-yard line. Nice run by Ian Laba.
And there's Ian, who's one of the backup ball carriers. Now, San Clemente is running the ball with that at ease. I don't understand why they would want to throw the ball, at least not at this point of the game when they're running the ball easily through El Toro.
Okay, second down, first and goal, ball on the 2-yard line. DeLancelotti is going to be up under center. Laba and Espino. Right in the backfield, split backs. The give around Gallegos, and he's in the touchdown, San Clemente. DJ Gallegos. And that touchdown was brought to you by our main sponsor, the OC Tavern, Mike Merrigan. Gallegos, he just came by the right side of the formation in motion, ran around the left side, and bowled across into the end zone.
Yeah.
There you go, Coach. There's your running score you're looking for.
Yep, and DJ did a nice job. He got hit at the 2-yard line and basically carried the tackler into the end zone. He was bound and determined to get in the end zone there.
So Gomez is going to be holding it. The hold, and Brandon Burr is going to be standing back, ready for the PAT. The snap, the kick is up. Nice job by Brandenburg. It's good. So at that, 3:28 here to go in the second quarter. San Clemente now leads 14-3, and maybe the San Clemente offense is awoken, Coach.
Yeah. No, they got their offense going.
Little slumber.
They're running the ball.
That's good. I think this time our coaching staff, Dave Brown, and I think they're below us in right below us now. We're on top here in the crow's nest. Actually, it's not too bad now. The wind died down. It was getting a little chilly there for a few, but now it's nice out here.
Good football weather.
Yeah, except Chris is freezing.
We don't care about Chris.
Yes, we do.
Just keep the camera going, Chris.
Nah, we care about Chris.
Yeah.
Don't get him upset. Yeah, Chris is showing you what's going to happen. You say you don't care about him. Chris, our computer technician.
We wouldn't be here without Chris.
No, we sure wouldn't. You wouldn't have this live video. That's for dang sure. He does a great job in the plays of the week. Downloads everything. He does a good job. Yeah, I was going to say, did you see that? The one official was signaling he was going, and the other one said he was in the end zone, and he clearly stepped in the end zone. Yeah. There was no doubt about that. Yeah. How did that other official right in front of him not see that?
I think he's old.
I think he's blind.
Well, you ought to be not to see that.
Oh, God, here we go again. So it's going to be first down and 10. Ball's going to be on the 20-yard line. El Toro moving left to right. 3:28 to go here in the second quarter. San Clemente ahead 14-3. El Toro comes out. Two receivers split to the right. The run around the right side of the formation for no gain. Andrew Wellman, the running back, maybe got maybe a yard, so it'll be second down and 9.
That was a nice job by Austin Klinkenbeard. Austin, one of the down linemen. The announcer gave Joey the credit, but Austin was the one that made the first hit and was there for the tackle.
Two receivers split to the right, single receiver split to the left, split backs. The quarterback fields up under center, five-step drop. Intercepted. Oh, it should have been Tober. Tober had it in his hands. Oh, man. William Tober just went off his hand. You know, he's playing with a broken thumb, so he's got an excuse. He's a great athlete. He stepped back there and stepped in front of that ball and just couldn't bring it in. But if you look at his right hand, he's got a broken thumb. He's got a cast on that thing. Oh, man, I'm looking at it right now with the binos. I don't know if you can zoom on that, Chris, but he's got a real large cast on it. So otherwise, he would have had that. But it's a good defensive job. Three receivers split to the left. Fields up under center. Three-step drop.
Oh.
It's batted down by San Clemente.
That was a nice job by Alex Kahn, who came up and knocked the ball down.
So San Clemente is going to end up getting the ball back here. It's going to be a punting situation. And they're going to have 2 minutes and 43 seconds here to go in the second quarter, leading 14-3. Possibly put more points on the board. Keep Coach Villa happy over here.
I'm happy.
He's happy. Dr. Doom is happy right now because his team scored running.
Yeah. And Graham's going to get the ball around the 45-yard line. He's going to get a nice run back. We'll have a good field position for another score.
Coaches, I told you, Coach is happy right now. We like to keep Ben happy. Uh-oh.
Oh, bad punt.
It's going to go out of bounds. Where are they going to spot that thing? Maybe at the 47-yard line. So at the 46-yard line, San Clemente is going to take over first and 10, moving right to left. 2:36 here to go in the second quarter. San Clemente ahead 14-3.
Well, this
is plenty of time.
This is, you're making score comparisons. Danny Hills beat El Toro by a score of 56-21. So Danny Hills put 56 points on the board. Chapel Valley put on 21 points against them.
Plenty of game left, Coach. Plenty of game. Spread formation. Three receivers to the right. DeLancelotti's back in. Another quarterback keeper at the left side. He's got some running room. He's on the way. He broke it to the 5. Touchdown, San Clemente. Duke DeLancelotti with 46-yard run. He just took one step back and broke off to the left side. And then he got hit by about two or three defenders, and he busted through them, ran all the way down to the end of the end zone. Nice job by Duke.
Too bad we don't have a replay, because I thought he was going to get tackled by two of the defenders who were coming up.
Both him.
And he just blew right by him.
That was a great job by old Duke, man. That's a way to go out there. We talked to him before the game. You'll be able to hear him at the halftime. And, Coach, I didn't get too out of control there. Just a little loud. Not bad. Vandenberg getting ready for the PAT. Kick is up. And the kick is good. And with that, 2:25, just like that, here to go in the second quarter. Sack of my head, 21-3. And Ben Gavir, there's your 21 points.
There's my 21 points.
You are happy. All we got to do is score the same, if not more, in the next half. And
I'm a happy camper.
You are a happy camper. Dr. Doom is happy as can be up here.
See, they're running the ball just like I thought they should be doing.
Just like you figured Duke would run a 46-yard run, quarterback keeper.
Yeah, I thought that Duke should be running more.
He's done a good job of running.
Yeah. Well, that's his passing will improve quite a lot when he runs, and the linebackers can't drop back into deep pass protection. They'll allow his receivers to roam a little more freer and give him some more passing opportunities, but he's just like having a third runner back there. He does a nice job running.
You don't see too many schools use this kick return like El Toro does. Oh, now that was the same thing. He was in the end zone. Oh, and he broke it. Got the kicker, Brandenburg. Oh, nice tackle by Brandenburg. And it's going to come out to the 48-yard line. But, Coach, I don't understand that. He stepped in the end zone. There's no doubt at all. Yeah. He stepped in the end zone.
And it was just like the last one.
Yeah, exactly, except with the ref on this side.
Yeah.
He's the one that overthrew it. He was in the end zone. I'm telling you, Titan fans, no doubt about that. Where's the Cox guys? They'll re-show that. He was in the end zone.
I told you they were old.
two split backs, quarterbacks up under center, give him around the left side.
Nice.
He's going to be dropped. Andrew Wellman for about a yard loss. Must be second down and 11, 2:06 and ticking here. Sacramento ahead 21-3 here in the second quarter.
That's a nice job by Joe Wilson, number 28, is the outside linebacker on the right side. We haven't mentioned Joe's name very much, but that's only because he does such an outstanding job out there that most teams will run to the opposite side of where he is, and then his main job is to turn all the runners in for the other linebackers to make the tackles.
Two receivers either side. Looks like they're just going to come out and just run the ball here. And he's going to get the Wellman. Oh, you know, now they blew the whistle, Coach.
Well, yeah, they blew the whistle, but he wasn't down.
I know, but he blew the whistle. Otherwise, you're right. That guy would have been. Who was that? Who grabbed the ball there?
Look, Eric Who's Patton. That? Coach Patton is arguing.
Yeah.
How can you blow the whistle when the man's not down?
You're right.
And he was. I mean, it's one thing for a ball carrier to be in danger of getting hurt, but it was just one tackle, one ball carrier, and the referee blew the whistle. There is no way that whistle should have been blown.
You're exactly right. That was Alex Kahn again, I think. Yeah, that was too bad because he pulled the ball away from him, and the official blew the whistle dead. So even though he had it, there's nothing he can do once the whistle blows. Boy, ask the San Diego Chargers here a couple weeks ago in Denver. Should have been a turnover. Game was over. Nope. Bad call.
But Sacramento should be able to overcome that little setback.
So it's going to be third down and about 13. 1:26 here to go in the second quarter. Sacramento ahead 21-3. Coach Ortiz, the defensive coordinator, was out there talking to the defense. Jaime does a great job of coaching the defense, and they have been playing real well this season so far. Same thing, Coach Dave Brown, the offensive coordinator. The offense has been clicking. So here comes El Toro. Dubs formation, two receivers split to either side, single back. Fields up under center. He's going to roll out to the right side. He's trying to throw a screen back up the middle. Gets a few yards back, maybe about 6 yards. It's going to come out to that 49-yard line to Wellman, the running back.
That was a nice tackle by Kyle Hill. We haven't called Kyle's name out very much. He's in on defense this time, and he stepped up and made a nice tackle.
All of a sudden, that wind is picking up here again. You got some of that fog blowing in. You can feel a little chilly again.
Yeah.
Look at those flags, man. They're blowing straight out.
Yeah. Take a picture of those flags.
Yeah, there you go, Chris.
The wind is blowing out here.
What is this? There's a mad cow running around out there, Coach? What's going on there, Coach?
Never mind. Don't listen to him.
There is. Oh, I see. They're down at. Coach, what? I'm looking down there. There's a couple.
There's a cow from Chick-fil-A and the El Toro mascot bull. They're getting together. The bull and the chick.
Oh, Coach. Oh, you're killing me. Anyway, talking about the Sacramento Titan defense here. 1:17 to go here. Second quarter, Sacramento ahead, 21-3. El Toro, two receiver split to the left, single receiver split to the right. Fields, the quarterback, up under center, two split backs. It's a toss, and he punts it. It's a quick kick. Man, I haven't seen that in years. Into the end zone.
The ball goes to the 20-yard line.
So, when's the last time we saw that, Coach?
I saw that when I was,
Back when you guys had leather helmets, right?
Leather helmet time, yeah. remind me the.
Who was Joe Jackson?
The cow and the bull down there. I was in east. I was back east in the New England area and went through Williams College and just happened to be there on a Saturday and they were having a football game against Tufts. And Williams College mascot is a cow. Their names were the Purple Cows.
Why, thank you, Coach.
You're welcome. I thought you'd enjoy that little
two
bit
receivers.
Of trivia.
I do. To Lancelotti. He's got an open receiver. Oh, Ela just overthrew him.
It was wide open.
Yeah, he sure was. And it's 1:03 here to go in the second quarter. Sacramento ahead, 21-3. And he would have been down about the 45-yard line. A couple more plays, at least would have been in field goal range.
Are thou sitting down?
What? What?
People. Rich is here sitting down. There's no way he can see the game.
I see right over there through the fence, Coach. They're lining up on the ball. Yeah. Two receivers split to the left. Not two receivers split to the right. Yeah, now I am. To Lancelotti and gun. Three-step drop, steps up.
Oh.
Off the hands of Gomez. And so it's going to be third down and 10. And you know what, Coach?
What?
Sacramento better be careful that they
why
don't
is
give.
Sacramento throwing the ball?
That's what I was going to say. They better be careful because they're going to turn the ball back over to El Toro with a little bit of time if they don't be careful.
See, now they're
going to get a first down.
They're going to have to run the ball to run the clock, and then El Toro is going to call a timeout so they can get the ball back for one more shot.
Nah, they're going to throw it here. Now they have to throw it.
Yeah, they have
third
to throw
10.
It now.
Two split. Receivers to either side, five-step drop, and he falls down. They're saying he was down, and he touched the ground when he slipped. And so that does make the ball,
now,
it's a dead ball, but luckily because he dropped the ball when he went down. Did you see that? The ball came out.
Now, how do they rationalize trying to go three passes when they're running the ball so well? Now they're going to punt, and Altoro's going to get a real good field goal. Field position, the punt returner is standing about the 40-yard line. Even if he gets an average punt return, he should get it back to about the 35 or 30. And then it only takes a couple of plays, and El Toro's already shown that they have a real good field goal kicker.
Well, you called it. You said going to pass, and then El Toro's going to call a timeout. And now they're going to get the ball back. We were just saying, you know what? Better be careful. You're going to give them back the ball here. And they got time, 48 seconds. I mean, that was a quick, what was that, about 15 seconds, 16, something like that, with about, three plays. And now all of a sudden, Sacramento's going to punt the ball, leading 21-3. But El Toro's going to get the ball back with 48 seconds to go, plenty of time. I figure they'll get, depending on the punt, they're going to get the ball probably around between the maybe 40, 35, 30-yard line, something like that.
Yeah.
We'll see what happens.
If I were the punt returner, I'd call a fair catch, so not to let any time run off the clock. Unless he gets a quick punt, gets the ball right away. But if he's got any height at all, he should just call a fair catch.
So Brandenburg punters up.
Oh, nice punt!
Oh, what a punt! Fair catch back at the 48-yard line. That was That was a great punt by Steve Brandenburg.
He got him out of trouble.
Oh, he sure the heck did. That was a 52-yard punt with 3-4 yards in the end zone, so maybe 56, something like that, yard punt.
And that's in the air.
Yeah, that was a great job by Brandenburg.
Boy, instead of El Toro having the ball in the between about the 35-yard line, they got it on their own 48.
Yeah, that was outstanding.
Was a great punt.
Three receivers split to the right. They got better watch that. That middle receiver is not covered. The pass is up. Off the hands. And I think you're going to get a penalty on the Sacramento defensive coverage there. Somebody had holding or something in Sacramento. That was one of the defensive backs, looks like.
I think somebody bumped him on the way out. He can't bump a receiver after five yards. So I think they're going to call.
Definitely.
Oh, there's going to be holding. He really got beat.
I just grabbed him as he ran by. Well, you can really see that cast on Tober's hand now. Number four, if you're looking out there, number four. He's got a huge cast on that right hand. So bunch formation to the right, three receivers. Single receiver split to the left. Quarterback up under center. He's got an open receiver.
Oh,
man, that was lucky.
I don't know how he missed that.
Yeah,
I think
no kidding.
I think you heard footsteps coming.
Something, boy. That was Morgan, the receiver, Elliot Morgan, and it was right off his hands. That was a great throw by the quarterback. Boy, El Toro is kicking themselves here.
Well, they've had two opportunities to make some good plays. But with 34 seconds, still only second down, I would probably be throwing anywhere from 10 to 12 yard passes and try to get a little bit closer to field goal range.
Dubs formation, fields up under center, five step drop.
Oh, he's going.
He's just throwing deep, and you know what? Ooh, man. That was unfortunately, well, fortunately for us, it was a lame duck pass, but yeah. That thing just hung up there. Wah, wah, wah.
Yeah, he didn't, he should have thrown that ball into the end zone. The receiver might have been able to get it, but he just threw that ball short.
So, Biggs, third down now and 10. Ball sitting right at the 42-yard line of San Clemente. San Clemente leading here in the second quarter, 21-3. 28 seconds to go before halftime. And El Toro comes out, two receivers split to the right, single receiver split to the left, two split backs. Fields up under center. San Clemente shows blitz, then they back off. Five-step drop, intercepted by San Clemente. Is that Gomez?
Gomez, get to the
on
outside.
On the left side.
Get to the outside.
Tuck that ball. He gets out to the 35-yard line. And now, believe it or not, Coach, San Clemente with that interception, they're going to get the ball back, and there's still 15 seconds on that clock. So that has been, what, six, seven plays, eight plays in about a minute and whatever that was, 25 seconds or something like that?
No.
Oh, that's amazing.
San Clemente probably take a knee right here.
No. They may put it down. They may put it down and try to get a long pass. I don't know. Run it. Maybe do a draw. You know, spread them out and then run a draw on the fullback.
And risk a fumble? I think I'd go down to one knee.
Oh, Ben, you kill me up here. Three receivers, spread to the right. Let's see what happens.
I guess he's not going down one knee.
There you go. Three-step. Pass. Complete. To Ela.
Timeout.
44-yard line. 8 seconds to go. Timeout, Sacramento. 21-3. And now we're on the 44-yard line.
Okay, Sacramento needs another 10-15 yards and another field goal range.
I don't think you're going to – how many timeouts do they have left? I don't know.
Timeout is called by San Clemente.
That may be their last one right there for San Clemente. So they don't have any timeouts left, so they're going to have to throw it down the end zone.
Yeah, throw it in the end zone. Be just as good as a punt.
See some of that down here, the coaches on the right, Del Toro, the coaches that were coaching against us today and yesterday. So 8 seconds to go, second quarter, San Clemente ahead, 21-3. Should be maybe a long Hail Mary pass and hope for a penalty. If that's the case, we'll get a shot maybe at a field goal. Brandenburg taking over tonight. He's doing a great job for Jones. Dubs formation, two receivers split to either side of the formation. Three-step drop, overthrown, almost intercepted. And they said, they still got three ticks on the clock to go. This has been, I cannot believe how many plays were run in less than a minute and whatever, 18, 20 seconds, whatever that was. That's amazing. Chris wants to go get some coffee or get some hot chocolate or something.
My feet are freezing. We're standing up here on an aluminum platform.
Yeah. We definitely are up high. Not the most comfortable thing situation we've had. Three receivers spread to the right.
Hail Mary.
Yep, there we go. Underneath to Ela, and that should do it. Was complete down at the 23-yard line. And with that, it's going to be the halftime. Sacramento ahead, 21-3. And so far, it's been mostly all Sacramento. We'll see what happens, how they adjust here at halftime.
We'll see you in a few minutes.
Welcome back, Triton fans. We're just getting ready to start the second half here. Sacramento ahead, 21-3. It's been a basically mistake-free for Sacramento. Kind of a sluggish first half, but we'll see what Sacramento does when they come back. You know, they've kept taking this field right now. You just missed it. I was going to try to show you Ben asleep in the corner here, but he saw me move, so he hopped up real quick. Anyway, I'm sure it'd be interesting to see what changes or what they need to do here in the locker room and what they're going to come out with in the second half. I think that San Clemente needs to come out and establish the running game again, get the running game going, and that's going to open up the passing game. And like I said, the first half a little bit sluggish. I feel that that San Clemente maybe was just looking a little bit ahead towards La Habra next week. You know, they're playing El Toro, who hasn't been doing very well, and sometimes you end up you play a team sometimes that is not doing real well, and then you end up playing down to their level. So I think you're going to see the coaching staff coach them up here at the halftime. They're going to come out and they're going to hopefully turn things around just to get it going, pick it up. They're not doing anything bad out here. They just need to pick it up a little bit. We got about a minute or two before we're going to start here. Both teams are just coming off the field. Wind is picking up.
My papers are flying everywhere.
Ben's papers are flying everywhere. Ben, who has been asleep for the last 15 minutes in the corner here, decided to wake up and join us.
I was napping.
You were napping. Ben calls that his power nap.
Power nap.
I just had someone come in. It was actually my sister from Sacramento, my sister Virginia. Called in and said, you guys enjoying the show. We're doing a great job. Thank you, Virginia. Keeping track of Sacramento for me while we're up here at Laguna Hills High School. Tonight, we're at Laguna Hills. That's where El Toro plays its home games. Normally, they've always played in the past at Tribuco, but Tribuco is under major construction in the parking area. They're building a parking structure, and it is a nightmare trying to park to get into that game. We had Tribuco a couple weeks ago, and apparently Laguna Hills, El Toro felt it better to come out here to Laguna Hills, where there's definitely a lot more room and no problems parking. So, Sacramento, I think they're going to come out. They ought to come out and run the ball and take time off the clock, get a few scores, and then pick up momentum and head into next week. It's not over yet. Anybody can come back. So, Ben, what are your thoughts about this, the first half?
Well, it wasn't up to Sacramento par, but they did put some three touchdowns on the board, and they're up 21-3. They weren't, first quarter weren't very consistent offensively. Defensively, they did a good job of keeping El Toro under control, but they can play better offensively, and hopefully they can. They got to get themselves ready against La Habra, because La Habra will be a tough opponent next week.
Yeah, they will. Just getting ready for the kickoff, Brandenburg. And starting off the second half here, ball will be fielded at the 2-yard line, no doubt about that one. Gets out to about the 20 to the 25, where it's going to be dropped at about the 26-yard line. El Toro's going to take over first and 10, moving left to right. Real quickly, I want to thank our Friday Night Live sponsors, the main sponsor of the OC Tavern, Mike Merrigan, Little Page Landscaping, Paul Littlepage, Littlepage Automotive, Mark Littlepage, South Coast Distributing, the Aarons family, Shirt Graphics, and Chris Miller, and our newest sponsor, R&R Custom Cabinets, Reno Roberti. We appreciate the support of Friday Night Live. A lot of these are local businessmen, ex-Triton alumni, and with their support, we're able to bring you this game live. So El Toro is going to take over first and 10, two receivers split to the right. The give, it's a quarterback or a halfback pass. Sacramento smells it out.
Oh, they're trying.
He's going to be dropped about the 20-yard line. Yeah, they tried to rip that ball out of his hands. the handoff to the halfback, and he was going to try a halfback pass.
And William Tober did a great job of staying where the receiver didn't commit to the to a run, and El Toro had nowhere to throw the ball. San Clemente's
personal foul.
Oh, personal foul.
San Clemente. Oh, that's not the way to come out and come out and after being talked to in the halftime and come out. They must have somehow when they were trying to grab the ball from the whoever that was going to throw it, the running back, maybe they grabbed, I don't know, they did something. That was a personal foul.
Ball is marched off to the 35-yard line where it'll be second and one for El Toro.
So El Toro's going to have now second and one. Ball's going to be right at the 35-yard line. It should be first. It's not first and one. Wait a minute. Now refs.
Alright.
Alright. So they went from second and one, first and one, second and one, now back second and one. So second and one, ball's at the 35-yard line. So quick formation, tight, to give on the right side. He's got running room for first down. He'll be knocked out of bounds, the running back, Andrew Wellman. So ball's going to be right at the 40-yard line. And again, apologize about the noise here. The loudspeaker for the announcer is just right outside Chris's ear next to me. And it is really loud. Like it's just like when we were at Tribuco. You get up there, you got the band below us, just like Tribuco. So it's a little loud up here. So anyway, first and 10, balls on the 40-yard line. 11:25 here to go in the third quarter. Opening minute, 21-3 San Clemente. To give up the middle of the formation for about 1 yard. Running back Kyle Smith.
Dylan Rita, Nate, been a nice job coming in from his inside linebacker position to stop the ball carrier for a 2 yard run.
So, second down and eight. 11:03 and ticking. Play comes in from the sideline. The quarterback, Cody Fields. Single receiver split to the right. Single receiver split to the left. Two split backs. Fields up under center. He's going to roll out around the left side. He's got a little bit of room. Completed pass down to the 48-yard line. Looked like complete to Kyle Smith. So it'll be third down and about two.
That was a nice play by El Toro. The quarterback gave himself a lot of time to throw the ball. He rolled to his left and found the open receiver. El Toro might have found a new passing offense because he had a lot of time on that rollout.
Single receiver to the left, give on the right side of the formation. Nowhere. Nice job by the San Clemente defense. Nowhere.
Big call by the coach. It's fourth and about two. Do you punt or do you go for it?
You got a punt.
It looks like he's going to go for it.
I would think they should punt. They shouldn't. Don't want to give the San Clemente the ball right here at the 48-yard line. They're going to go ahead and go for it. You know what they're probably going to do is just try to calm off sides here. Maybe just keep barking out the audibles.
Yeah.
Let's see what they do, see if they can drive San Clemente offside. Watch the ball, guys. Watch the ball. Two receivers to the right, single receiver to the left. I formation. Fields up under center. Now they're going to go for it. He's trying a long pass, and he's got an open receiver, and it is defended well.
Great job by Jordan Gerardo. Came from the safety position to knock that ball down.
Coach, that was not a very smart play.
No. But you know what? He was even smarter with Jordan. He didn't intercept it.
Right.
If he had intercepted, the ball would have been back there. He knocked it down, and the ball goes to the original line of scrimmage. If he had intercepted, got tackled, El Toro would have gained like 20 yards just on that interception. So that was a great play by Gerardo, knocking the ball down and thinking intelligently and not intercepting it.
So DeLancelotti and Gunn, two receivers split to the left, motion. The giver on the left side to Gomez. Gets up to about the 39-yard line where it's going to be second down and seven. Nice run by Gomez who came from right to left.
You think we can run the rest of the timer?
I think we could, Coach. Now, are you asking me do I think we will?
Yeah, well, do you think we will?
No, why?
Well, I was just kind of curious.
Oh, you kill me. 8:56 and ticking here in the third quarter. 21-3, San Clemente ahead. Second down and three. Two receivers to the right. Motion to give to Gallegos, who stops and tries to cut it back up, and it's going to be close to a first down, maybe a little short. DJ Gallegos. Depends where the spot is. It's going to be just a little short. Yeah, maybe a couple feet, maybe, or a foot, something. So third down and a short something.
Now it says third and one, but it looks like third and
less than, one foot. Exactly. Can you say quarterback keeper, coach? Oh, timeout?
No, I can say timeout.
Timeout has been called.
Coach, don't start. We just started now. Come on, let's have a clean slate here.
How often do you see teams call timeout with a third and a foot? They go over there and call a play, and they lose 15 yards.
Oh, geez. Dr. Doom.
You have to call timeout to lose yardage?
Coach, please.
Why do you need a timeout to call a quarterback sneak?
Well, we don't know that's going to happen. I would assume that's what's going to happen.
Why do you need a timeout to call a dive off the tackle? Why do you need a timeout to tell DJ, you're going to carry the ball, get us the first. All right, coach.
Oh, Ben. That power nap just made you more cranky, coach.
I know. And Diego's not even in there. David Spino and Lawbar are in there at the running backs.
So DeLance Lott is going to be up in the center. He's going to quarterback sneak this. At least maybe that's what they want to do, but they're ready for that. Sacramento ought to go around the right side right now. Motion. Give up the left side. They stopped
them. What did
them.
I tell you?
They
stopped them. Timeout for that play?
Hey, but Come Coach, on. You said they're going to lose 15 yards. They only lost one.
Lost a yard.
I don't know. I don't know if you saw, Coach, but you see how they're all bunched in the middle right then. Yeah. Had we run around the right side of the formation right then, we would have had some running room there.
Yeah, we've been gaining yards around the end.
Now, they definitely were ready for the inside run. That let's see what happens. It's still fourth down, and now it's fourth down and about one and a half.
Uh-oh, time's running. They were missing a player. Ben Gomez wasn't out there. Now they got a hurt.
They're hurry up. Three receivers split to the right. They had to run it to the right. He had to just boot it. Oh, man.
Oh, my God.
Right now, as they hiked it.
I would be a little bit upset right now.
Now they're going to punt.
Now they have to punt. You call a timeout to call a player that loses the yards, and then you can't get the team out there to snap the ball on fourth down because you're going for it. You get a five-yard penalty. Now, how many mistakes do you have to make in one series? Wow.
Now we got Ben going again. Oh, Lord. Look, sorry, Titan fans. We've got the wrath of Ben going there. Punt formation, 7:23 here to go in third quarter. San Clemente ahead, 21-3. Not the best offensive series we've seen. And this one goes out of bounds. Maybe right around the 20 somewhere?
No.
A little bit farther? 15, 16? 16? 17? El Toro's going to take over, moving left to right. First down, 7:13 to go here in the third quarter. San Clemente ahead, 21-3. And on both sides of the ball that time, not real good offensive plays on the last by El Toro and then San Clemente. So, San Clemente defense on the field again. Two receivers split to the left side for El Toro. Single receiver split to the right. I formation. Fields up under center. Said takes a three-step drop and tries to throw a quick little slant over here to the right side. Well defended.
Yeah, the receiver was almost open, but the quarterback threw it behind him. The receiver couldn't get back to the ball. Just San Clemente just does not look like that team that overpowered Tribuco last week. It's not the same team.
Give up the middle for about a 2-yard gain. So it's going to be third down and about eight. Ray Villanueva, the head coach and the offensive coordinator from the JV team, he's at home on the couch right now, probably drinking a malt or something. And he's telling us, he's suggesting a few plays that we should call down to the coaches below us. He says, run the inside. I won't say exactly what it is, but okay, Ray. Hey, we're thinking of you, buddy. Ray, always coaching, whether home or at a game. .6:30 to go. San Clemente ahead, 21-3. Timeout. Timeout now on Toro. Man, this has been kind of a strange start here. Timeouts, well, penalties.
You got a timeout. No, you call a timeout, third and about 8 yards to go. Coach pulls out his playbook. Is there a play in his book that will get you a first down, third and eight?
Coach on page three. Yeah. A 10-yard hitch.
Yeah. This play guarantees a first down. We're down on the 19-yard line.
Well, we're seeing they're digging deep here. You're right. Like you just said, they're looking out and they're going, okay, we got to have it's 8 yards to go, so about a 10-yard pass here. You could have a 10-yard hitch, maybe a post.
He's reminding the receivers.
10-yard out.
He's reminding the receivers, remember, you got to go 10 yards on your patterns.
That's one thing. You always have to know down and distance. It's one thing we teach them in football. Know down and distance. So, here we go. Let's see what the big third down play is after the timeout.
So what play the coach pulled out for a first down. Maybe we can use it in San Clemente.
Two receivers split to the left. Single receiver split to the right. Split back. Fields up under center. Five-step drop. And he has a...
Oh!
What did I tell you, Coach? A 10-yard hitch over on the left side for a first down. El Toro. Coach Corder called that one. That was
yes,
complete
did, except
to Jesse Bueno.
Except he was throwing to the wrong guy.
Oh, my. He just said that because I had it right, Coach. Thanks a lot. So, first down and 10. Ball's going to be on the 30-yard line. 6:15 to go here in the third quarter. San Clemente ahead, 21-3.
Well, the coach did pull out a good play.
He did.
The receivers went the distance to get the first.
10-yard hitch. Got to know down and distance. Two receivers split to the right. High formation, Fields up under center. Throwing a pass, complete. Out to the 48-yard line, gets across to the... It's Tober trying to wrestle it away from him. To Bueno again, number 18. That's two big plays by Bueno, the receiver for El Toro.
Well, Bueno's got a very distinct height advantage over William Tober. Bueno's got about at least 6 inches of height on him.
Somebody just tuned in the game from Lawton, Oklahoma.
Lawton.
Who are you? Tell us who you are and who you know here.
Lawton, Oklahoma. Wurtsville. I spent many months there.
All righty. So a run around the left, 1 yard gain, second yard of 9, clock ticking, 5:23, San Clemente ahead, 21-3. So whoever just signed in from Oklahoma, let us know, are you ex-Triton alumni? Do you have family here? Are you family of one of the Triton guys playing tonight?
Right now, everybody's at Lawton High School watching Lawton High School play. Tomorrow, they all pack it up and go to Cameron College to watch Cameron play on Saturday night.
Coach.
And all the elementary schools play football on Thursdays.
All right, Coach.
Ah.
How do you know that, Coach?
I was there.
Two receivers split to the right. Motion. San Clemente almost jumps outside. The give back to the left side. The running back, number 33, Wellman. So it's going to be third down and about, maybe 6 or 7.
That was a nice job by Austin Klinkenbeard, who came off the defensive line, got into the backfield, was able to slow him down. Austin put some pressure on the offensive line, was able to get there and slow down the ball carrier.
Okay. Third down and a long 7. Two receivers split to the right. Single receiver split to the left. Two split backs. Fields, the quarterback from El Toro, up under center. Motion. The running back, Wellman. Quarterback's going to boot out, and he's going to get it. A blitz. Blitz was on, and he gets dropped back at the 47-yard line. It's a nice blitz by San Clemente.
The quarterback Fields just ran right into it. He turned, rolled to his right, and ran right into the linebacker, San Clemente's linebackers, and got thrown for a loss. That was a nice call by Jaime Ortiz, the defensive coordinator, who made that call. Sacramento was there to make the play.
Yeah, nice job by Jaime. Boy, look at this formation, their punt formation. Three receivers split out here to the right. They have to have, and they got to have guys get on them. Punts away. Be filled by Tenney.
Tenney gets a...
Hey, broke back, got another couple yards. So he's going to be out close to the 15-yard line. Sacramento's going to take over, moving right to left, across your screen. 3:14 to go here in the third quarter. Sacramento ahead 21-3, and the third quarter has been a little sloppy. A little sloppy out here. Coach, all your fault.
Well, hey. I'm a big boy. I can take responsibility.
Always wondering what's going to come out of the mouth of Coach Villa. Two receivers split to the left, two receivers split to the right. To Lancelotti and Gunn. To give to Espino, who's cut down in the line of scrimmage, might be a yard gain. Boy, they've kind of shut down Espino tonight.
Yeah, they've done a good job stopping him.
The difference tonight is that we're missing Ryan De Leon. When you have De Leon, Espino, and Gallegos out there, then you've got three different type of running backs. Now it's be a little bit limited. We're getting some scores coming in here. Anything in the South Coast League? Got an open receiver on the right side.
Oh, stay on your feet. Oh.
Gets down to the 40-yard line. That was a nice catch by Kubley. So it's a first down. Nice pass from Lancelotti.
Brandon Kubley hasn't played a whole lot this year, but now he's getting an opportunity to play some offense. And his first opportunity makes a reception for a nice catch and a first down.
So we got a couple scores in right now. Mission Viejo over Murrieta, 28-6, probably in the third quarter. And then Dana Hills over losing to Newport, 14-6. Thread formation. Tenney catches the ball. Nice job. He gets dropped at the 38-yard line. Is he hurt, Coach?
No.
He's limping.
I got a tweak.
A tweak?
I got a tweak.
Coach, define that, Coach. What's a tweak?
A tweak is just short of a bruise.
Kappa Valley is leading 10-7. Should be in the over Valencia. Should be in the third quarter. Three receivers spread to the right. To Lancelotti and Gunn, Espino to his right. Three-step drop.
Nice
complete to Ela over the middle of the formation. Gets out to about the 33-yard line, where it's going to be second down and about three. 1:40 to go here.
San Clemente is doing a nice job of running Ben Gomez deep. Penny's running the medium routes, and Dominic Ela is running the short routes across the middle.
Three receivers spread to the right. Gun formation to give to Espino, has nowhere. He cuts it back and just nowhere to go. Good job by the El Toro defense. And it's going to be third down and about five. Say what?
Cameron does not have football anymore? Oh, my goodness. Cameron was a big, big community college powerhouse in Oklahoma. They were always nationally ranked.
Badminton.
Now they're...
Bingo. Bingo on Friday nights.
Maybe all the football players moved out.
Two split receivers. Big third down. He's got an open field. Tenney, he went backwards. He stepped backwards. Tenney had it. He actually had it. Was close to the first down, but then he should have stuck his head down and gone forward. So it's going to be fourth down and one. I bet you they go for it, Coach.
They're going to go for it. At the 40-yard line, not at the 30-yard line. Now, this time they don't call a timeout.
Here we go. Quarterback sneak right here, Coach. Quarterback sneak. There he goes, first down.
See,
nice job.
Did you need a timeout to call that play?
I didn't say they did, Coach. What are you yelling at me for? I just said you made a first down.
Yeah, but you were second-guessing me on the...
I
told you they didn't need to call a timeout to call a play that lost them another yard.
First down and 10. Ball's going to be just about the 27-yard line. 10 seconds to go here in the third quarter. San Clemente ahead, 21-3. And two receivers split to either side of the formation. Will they get the playoff? It's going to be close. One, bam, not enough.
All right, we're going to go into the fourth quarter.
Fourth quarter, that's the end of the third quarter. San Clemente ahead, 21-3. And we want to thank our sponsors here at the end of the third quarter, our Friday Night Live sponsors for the 2008 season. Our main sponsor, the OC Tavern and Mike Merrigan. Little Page Landscaping, Paul Little Page. Little Page Automotive, Mark Little Page. South Coast Distributing, the Aarons family. Shirt Graphics, Chris Miller. R&R Custom Cabinets, Reno Roberti. We appreciate your support from Friday Night Live. You guys are keeping us going out there. Well, Ben, no change in score there at the third quarter.
No change in score.
Still 21-3.
No change in the way that they're playing.
Oh, Pondo's on there.
Pondo, you're a good guy.
Pondo's typing in from San Clemente. We coached with Pondo. And actually, Ben, you coached him, right? Is that what he said?
Yeah, matter of fact, I don't want to tell everybody how old I am, but Pondo played for me when he was 12 years old.
90.
Well, yeah, and you know what's nice? I may be aging myself, but what's nice is that John Hamrow, the AD of San Clemente, played for me. I've known him since he was 8 years old. Mike Hurled Up, Bud, who's also teaching San Clemente, played for me when he was 12 years old. So it's nice. Thank you for the compliment, Pondo. I appreciate it.
Here you go. Dubs formation. Gun. Lancelot steps back as open receiver on the left side. Gets running room. Gets out close to the first down. That was Kubli. It's going to be close to the first down. Looks like it is a first down. That should move the chains.
And Brandon Kubli steps up and makes a couple of fine receptions. And his coming out, he does his first time. He's actually put in some extensive time on the offense. So he stepped up and made a couple of nice catches.
Spread formation. Coach, you're not complaining that they're throwing the ball. What's going on there, Coach? Spread formation. Three receivers to the right.
I'll complain after this play.
The Lancelotti and Gunn. It's going to be the option on the left side. Lancelotti keeps it. Penalty. He gets into the end zone. But I think we're going to have a holding call on San Clemente.
I think it's going to be against Ben Gomez, who was the wide receiver who went out there.
Oh, man. The Lancelotti. Now, didn't that happen on the when DeLancelotti ran the last one? Didn't they have a holding play on that? Holding? No?
No.
Are you sure about that?
I'm not sure, but I'm positive. But here,
so who's it?
How do you, I don't know. It just boggles my mind that you have these opportunities to score, opportunities to make a good play, and they commit a penalty that just negates all their good work.
So first down, two receivers either side of the formation. The Lancelotti, a little winded after that last run, in gun. Takes a three-step drop. He's got a receiver open. Touchdown, San Clemente, Ben Gomez. Nice pass from DeLancelotti to Ben Gomez. And just like that, San Clemente scores. That score is brought to you by one of our sponsors, Little Page Landscaping, and Paul Little Page.
After the penalty, Ben Gomez probably told Duke, throw me the ball. I'll get in and I'll score it.
Yeah.
He had to make up for the penalty. That was a nice throw, nice catch by Ben.
Yeah, it was. Gomez just ran a little fade route right down the middle of the formation, and nice job by DeLancelotti getting to the ball. Now Ben's getting ready to hold the PAT attempt, and the kick is up by Brandenburg, and he has done a great job of coming in and filling in for Aaron Jones tonight. It's now 28-3, and there you go, Kurtz. There's your other score, 28-3 now.
Yep, 28-3.
So now we matched up with, who was that you were saying, Tribuco?
No.
Who was it?
Not yet. For those
28 points, you said, the one school, you said they scored 28 points on them?
No, for those people out there who want to make score comparisons, Dana Hills beat El Toro 56-21, and Capo beat him 21-17.
I knew it was a 20-something. All right, now we have 28-3. All San Clemente tonight. San Clemente gearing up for a big showdown next week at San Clemente. La Habra coming in. We're going to have a tough game, too, against their freshman team. Their freshman team's big, and they got a big running back. Our freshman team in in 8 games of rush for 1,050 yards. And the kick's going to be into the end zone. It's going to come out the 20-yard line where El Toro is going to take over first and 10, moving right to left across the computer screen. Like I said, Ben, did I tell you that earlier today we added up the rushing after our game yesterday in the first 4 games, 1,050 yards in 4 games. Great job. We have just been pounding the ball. And actually been throwing some too. Great quarterback, Travis Wilson. And we're looking good. We have a good shot to go for league. Going to be a tough South Coast league, but we're going to get back. 2 split backs, 2 receivers split to the right. Quarterback fields up under center. Throws the ball. The receiver just was kind of got turned around. He went to which way to run.
Well, he was stuck between 2 defenders, a linebacker and a cornerback. Didn't know which way to go.
Be interesting to see how that just showed up on the film.
Yeah, this is gonna be a long quarter. Because now 28-3, El Toro is basically relegated to having to throw the ball to try to catch
right.
up. So
stop the clock.
We'll
every
be stopping
time.
The clock quite a bit.
Here comes a hurricane wind. Ben is blowing away on me right here. Ben, batten down the hatches. But Ben's closing his book. He's not worried about it.
Book is closed.
Quarterback up under center. 2 split receivers to either side. They give on the right side. Little bit of running room. Gets out to about the 25-yard line, the running back, Andrew Wellman. So bring up 3rd down and about 4. 11:02 to go in the fourth quarter. San Clemente ahead, 28-3. Let me ask you this, Ben. Is San Clemente going to score again tonight? Big question for you, Ben.
Yes.
All right, Dr. Doom.
Don't score one more time.
Oh, Dr. Doom, you're all right tonight.
But it's going to be the defense that scores it.
Okay, so tried to run to the left side, and it's going to be smothered by the San Clemente defense for no gain, maybe even a loss of a yard. Yep, this is supposed to be 4th down and 5. They got a punt here. You can't go for it here. They got a punt now. Ben, you'd get your score for sure there.
No.
So Tanny's limping a little bit. You see him going out in the field, Coach? Look at that. Why wouldn't they get somebody else in for him? He's limping.
Oh, he's a tough kid.
Not a heck with him. Yeah. Throw him to the wolves.
Tough kid.
So Tanny's standing back on the 37-yard line.
He doesn't know. He's not going to know it hurts until after the game.
Adrenaline rush. Getting ready for the punt. 9:56 to go in the fourth quarter. San Clemente ahead, 28-3. Oh, we got a few plays of the week coming up here. Got some scoring. Punt. Get away. It's going to take a El Toro roll and go down around the 30-yard line where it's going to be touched. And San Clemente is going to take over, moving left to right. First down on the 30-yard line.
Well, San Clemente now will be relegated to running the ball. That doesn't necessarily mean they're going to run the ball. But they just need to run the clock as much as they can. Their running offense has been working very well tonight, so I would assume that they're going to run the ball and just pound El Toro.
9:36 to go here in the fourth quarter. San Clemente ahead, 28-3. Going to have a single receiver split to the left. DeLancelotti is still the quarterback. The lone setback to the left is David Espino. Motion. The give to Espino. Fumble. I think El Toro has that, Coach.
I think
El Toro has it. Yes, he does. That's it. You know what? I'm not going to pick up my binoculars anymore. Look, every time I do that, the ball gets fumbled. So Espino, he took the handoff, but then he got hit right away, and the ball popped out, and sure as heck, El Toro fell on it, and just like that, El Toro's got the ball on the 32-yard line.
Yeah, Davis had a tough time tonight.
Somebody just sent us the roster from La Habra. We got 280, 245, 275, 245. They're big 280. 6'6", 290 senior. Gonna be a big school coming in here next week at San Clemente Falassa Stadium.
Well, we'll be fine.
Huh?
We'll be fine.
Oh, we'll be fine.
Yeah. As long as we don't get in a fight with them. Okay.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Well, you in LA, we'll be at the booth. We'll be Chris will protect us. Two receivers split to the right. To give. Gets up to about the 25, 26 yard line, where it's going to be third down and about four. Clock is ticking, 8:54 and ticking. San Clemente ahead, 28-3 here in the fourth quarter.
And here, Toro is running the ball on San Clemente and making some yardage too. So now we have a third down and about 4 yards to go. So San Clemente's got to suck it up here because El Toro definitely going to go on the fourth down.
Two receivers split to the right, two split backs. Single receiver split to the left. Quarterback's up in the center. Fields. Motion to give back around the right side. It's going to be close to a first down.
Looks like he got it.
Yes, yes, real close.
Real close.
Wellman was the carrier.
And they're going to go for it.
Mark Vidal again in on the stop.
Maybe,
now, Coach.
Maybe El Toro will call a timeout and try and set up a play here.
Did you notice, Coach, I did not make fun of you when he said Dana Hills, even though you made fun of me when I said Espino's name wrong one time.
You noticed.
Here I am, Coach, being the team player that I am. I did not, everybody's listening to me now, right, make fun of you when you said Dana Hills, and it's actually El Toro. I did not make fun of you, Coach. Coach's not talking to me anymore.
Yes, but I only said it once.
I know. Well, that's a thought that counts. Two receivers spread to the right. Single receiver spread to the left. Field's going to be up under center, two split backs. 7:59, the clock is ticking. San Clemente ahead, 28-3. Motion. To give. Nothing. He was. He's going to lose a yard. So it's going to be second down and 11. Boy, he didn't get anywhere.
That was a nice job by Khan. Alex Khan has stepped up into the hole and stopped him for no gain.
You know, Connor's had a great game tonight.
Yes, he has.
I think this is his best game so far of the year. He's had a great job. Done a great job. 7:22 and ticking. San Clemente ahead, 28-3. Second down and 11. El Toro, two receivers split to the right. Single receiver split to the left. Two split backs. Quarterback Fields up under center. Three-step drop. Quick look in. And he bobbles the ball, and he's going to get stopped. He dropped maybe back to the line of scrimmage to Bueno. Bueno earlier burned us on a couple long passes.
Yeah, Bueno took about two steps to go downfield, then came back and caught the ball behind the line of scrimmage.
And
and San Clemente's defensive pursuit got to him, and he didn't go for too much of a game.
He bobbled a little bit, so kind of slowed them up, and then San Clemente swarmed. So, third down and a long 11, 6:29 and ticking here in the fourth quarter. San Clemente ahead, 28-3. Bunch formation, three receivers to the left, single receiver to the right. Fields up under center. He's going to roll out to the right side. He's got a lot of pressure, and he's going to get knocked down, fumble. Is that a fumble? No, are they saying he's down? San Clemente has the ball. They must have said he's down, and the ball is going to be back, way back, at the 37-yard line.
That was a nice job by Straw, who came out from the outside to slow him down and had a hand on him, and then Alex Khan came up there to clean up.
You just hear the announcer below us, Coach, because it's going to be fourth down and an awful lot. That's something like Wood say. Maybe he's listening to us.
Here's a 53-yard field goal.
Kick is up.
He had the distance though.
That was just off to the right. Man, that was shoot. That would have been a 53-yard field goal. So San Clemente's going to take over. 5:30 here to go in the fourth quarter. San Clemente ahead, 28-3.
Well, San Clemente has been fortunate that their errors and their turnovers haven't hurt them. It's just that San Clemente is the more dominant team tonight, and here they can commit those errors and not be hurt. They wouldn't be able to do that against a really good team.
to Lancelotti and gun motion. It's got a penalty flag. The back coming in motion was Metcalf. So 5 yard penalty, first and 15. Might start seeing a few new players into the game. San Clemente leading 28-3 with 5:28 to go.
Yeah, they have Michael up running the ball on that particular play. The sophomore running back.
All right, little war music going on by the band here. I like this, coach. This is our muse. Coach is dancing. Motion to give up the left side to Espino. Man, Espino's got no running room again.
They
were keying on him tonight, coach.
David has had a tough time tonight.
Probably Ray Medina. I didn't notice.
Well, we've got 5 minutes and 5 seconds left on the clock. And Sacramento's going to do everything they can to run that clock down. They've got second and 13.
The giver on the right side. He's got some running room.
Now is Michael
that
up?
Was Mickliff out there. Gets out to about the 28-yard line. And we see old Ray Ray's out there. I thought I saw Ray Ray Medina. Is that him out there?
Yeah,
coming
number 32.
Yes, yeah. It is. That's our guy, Ray Ray. We call him the pinball. And he got that nickname as a freshman playing for us. We were playing against Aliso. He ran about, I'd say at least 50 yards. Maybe a little bit more, right around there. Ran for a touchdown, but as he was going down the field, he was just like a pinball, just bouncing off receiver, bouncing. He's so low to the ground, and he scored that touchdown. After that, we call him pinball. He's out there now. Two receivers split to either side of the formation. The Lancelotti and gun. When do you pull the Lancelotti here, coach? 4 minutes to go. And Ray Ray gets the ball around the left side. He's got some running room. First down.
Gets down to the 40-yard line
where it's going to be first down, maybe about the 42-yard line.
He had one guy to beat and got tripped up. A nice run by Ray.
That would have been something had he done just what we're just talking about. That was a good run by Ray. Penalty is coming back.
And what did I tell you? They just can't handle good things happening. They gotta do something bad to ruin it.
Oh man. Dr. Doom up here. You got him all jacked up again. Thanks a lot. After he was all excited about Ray Ray.
Yeah. So that was a great run.
Third down and five. It was. Third down and five. He's gonna run again, coach. We'll see who gets the ball this time. Is he still out there?
Nope. They're throwing the ball.
They fired him. Spread formation. Three receivers to the right. To Lancelotti and gun. Three-step drop. He's got an open receiver. Gets down to the first. 40. Out to the 44-yard line where they got the first down back. So, first down. I don't know about keeping DeLancelotti in there now, coach. You know, it's 28-3. Get him out of the game.
I don't think the coaches realize he's still in the game.
Yeah, I hope so.
Nice catch, Johnny Martinez. That was a nice catch by Ela, who's made, I believe, 4 receptions tonight. And again, he made that catch coming across the middle about 10 yards from the line of scrimmage on a 10-yard pattern, and then was able to pick up another 5-7 more yards for a first down.
We need to get Martinez in this game. Get him out of here. They're in right now. Johnny Martinez is in the game. He's going to give the right side of the formation. Was that Lava? Yeah, Lava down to the 49-yard line. So Johnny Martinez is in now. He's the junior quarterback. Let's see, any new scores? Edison, ahead of modern day, 17-7 in the third quarter.
Wow.
Capo Valley trailing now Valencia 21-17. Dana Hill's still behind 14-6. Some of those are so old scores. Dubs formation. Option on the left side. Martinez pitches to Lava, and he gets back to the line of scrimmage where it's going to be third down and about 6. 2:15 to go here in the fourth quarter. San Clemente ahead 28-3. Uh-oh, Ben, your prediction that San Clemente is going to score again.
Yep.
Here we go. You got 2 minutes and 15 seconds. Of course, you could always say you thought I was talking about next week.
Next week.
They'll score again. You weren't talking about tonight. No. Oh, I get it.
Yeah.
Man, this...
I think everybody's kind of looking forward to that La Habra ball game. La Habra's got... they have an outstanding football team.
Big.
They're going to be a big challenge to San Clemente. And if they can get through that one, it'd be a nice win once they head into league play.
We open up league after La Habra. We open up Dana Hills. Then we play Tesoro. Then we play Mission. Then we play Capo. Then we play Aliso.
So next four games are going to be against ranked teams.
Yes, that's right. Three of them are going to be at home. Against La Habra, Dana, and then Tesoro. And then we got to go to Mission, which will probably be a showdown for league.
Friday night, November
7th. That's what we're hoping.
Those will be great games to come watch. So we invite you to come to personally watch those ball games. If you can, you can listen in to us.
That's exactly right. Two receivers split the other side of the formation, Martinez and Gunn. They give up the – no, it's a quarterback keeper, and he gets maybe a yard.
Sonny Martinez now the quarterback, and he –
It almost looked like he was going to hand off to Laba, and Laba kind of passed him by, and he kind of just took it and ran. I'm not sure if that was a call play there. Brandon Bear's coming out. He's standing back around that 35-yard line, and he has done an outstanding job of punting and kicking the ball tonight, filling in for Aaron Jones. Great job by Steve Brandenburg, who we saw all week practicing. 1:41 and ticking. Nice punt. And it's going to take a little bit of a bounce, not much, so it'll be out.
That's a nice
maybe around a 13-yard line.
30, 40,
El Toro take 40. Over first and 10.
That was a 46-yard punt.
Yeah, he's done a great job of kicking tonight, both kicking and punting. Well,
a minute 30 seconds, I think we can. Where's Don Meredith? Just saying the party's over.
Yeah, what did happen to Aaron Jones? Do you know, Coach? Did they tell you what happened?
Yeah, he got a hyperextended muscle on his leg.
Run, it's going to be.
It was during practice. So he's just out for this game. They're just going to be cautious with him. Aaron also plays, is one of the DBs, so.
He will
be more useful next week.
El Toro just ran the ball, tried to run around the left side of the formation, didn't have any room, ran back on the right side, got 8 yards, so it's second down and two. Two receivers split to either side of the formation. Quarterback takes a three-step drop. They're going a long pass, overthrown by about 8 yards. Roy Brody, the receiver, number one. So third and two.
Brody beat Josh Left, our cornerback, but unfortunately for San Clemente, Fields overthrew him.
Ryan Lewis now is the new quarterback for El Toro, number 14. He gets the play from the sideline. 50 seconds left to go, 28-3 here in the fourth quarter. Three receivers spread to the left, single receiver spread to the right. The quarterback up under center takes a three-step drop, and he's going to run it. He's got running room for a first down. He breaks a tackle, breaks another tackle, gets across to the 42-yard line. All right, new quarterback. He's a little guy, too. All right, Sean Lee. So, first down. Ball's going to be on the 42-yard line. And El Toro's not giving up. Three receivers, spread to the left. Three-step drop, open. Oh, and an open receiver. Down around the 45-yard line. Or make that would have been the 35. He just overthrew him.
Yeah, he was way open, too.
Yeah, he was. So that stops the clock, 31 seconds. Actually, that last quarter went a lot quicker than we thought it was going to be.
Yeah, the inside linebackers are now Sean Lee and Kyle Hill are coming in to fill in.
Two receivers split to either side of the formation. Kyle Hill, Lee both played for us. He's going to roll out to the left side. He's being chased. It's caught complete for a first down out to the 44-yard line to Wellman. It's a nice catch. Nice pass by that quarterback.
Yeah, that was a nice floater he put out there just perfectly for the receiver to get it. And
Brian Lewis, they have him listed at 4'6", but Coach, I think they are cheating a couple. Not 4'6", 5'6". Two receivers split to the right. Two split backs. Lewis, the quarterback. Now the receiver comes back over on the left. 5-step drop. Just overthrow the receiver. Nice defensive coverage by San Clemente. 16 seconds, clock stop.
Brian Adams and Dylan Keim were back there defending.
All right, Dylan Keim. Adams, both lived on the just up one around the corner from me a few years ago, and just another one up a few houses, the Kleins, or Kynes. Three receivers to the right. Quarterback's going to sprint out. He's looking to go deep. Oh, he's got a receiver underneath.
There was no one within 10 yards.
No, that was Andrew Wellman. So he's down. They want to score, but the problem is they only got 6 seconds.
Well, I think I'd be throwing in the end zone.
That's true. So here we go. Oh, Ben, your score. Are they going to get it on this play? The clock is going to start ticking. And this is going to be the last play. He wants to go to the end zone. He has a receiver.
No, that was no good.
It was underneath. No, that was underneath.
Close.
It was nice, but the ball, when he landed, that ball was underneath of him.
Well, ladies and
gentlemen, that's
going
to do it. And that's the end of this game here with the score 28-3. San Clemente wins the game, and now we go back home next week. God, you cannot hear it. They're screaming next to us. We go home next week for La Habra, and that's going to be a huge game. Like Ben said earlier, if you can't make it to the game, tune in to Friday Night Live. We'd sure love to hear from you. It's going to be a big game.
Yeah, I would encourage you to come watch the ball games. The next four games for San Clemente are going to be real tough. They'll probably be the toughest competition. That's going to be the hardest part of their schedule. They got La Habra, Dana Hills, then Mission Viejo, Tesoro. They're gonna feel the pressure of the next four games. So hopefully you can all make it out. If you can't, hopefully you can listen in to
Friday Night Live.
Rich and his oratory, and maybe sometimes I can squeeze in there and say something.
Yeah, right. Let's see what the fans say.
Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, it's been nice. It's been a pleasure. Hope you'll join us again next week. Take care, and all you have a nice weekend.
And we'll see you Friday Night Live out.